Alright, then welcome back everyone. So in this video, let's continue our series and solve this question, sequence game. Now, it's a very big question actually if you see, if you first encounter in a contest. But don't worry, it was a Div 3 contest and it's B. So if it's a Div 3 contest, you would be able to solve the first three questions if you just know C++. Okay, I have already told you in my previous videos. It's a big question, but let's read the question, try to make sense out of it. Fine. So, Tima and Vika are playing the following game. What is that game? Vika comes up with a sequence of positive integers. Okay, so since it is a AB question or an 800-rated question, I mean, in the contest, you will not know it's an 800-rated question, but you know the difficulty of the question by A and B. So, always look out for a trick and constraint. The answer is somewhere hidden there. Fine. So, Vika comes up with a sequence of positive integers A of length n and writes it down in a piece of paper. Then she takes a new piece of paper and writes down the sequence B according to following rule. So basically it seems like we have an array A sequence and it is then converted to another array B, sequence B, according to the following rule. She writes down even, the first element is copied as it is. She writes down only those AI for remaining elements from second to the last element such that AI is greater than or equal to A minus. So basically she writes down only those elements that are greater than its previous element. Fine. So this is what it does. So first, this girl, Vika, comes up with a sequence A and then she converts it into the sequence B using these two rules. We'll see in an example here, don't worry. So, let the length of sequence, this sequence B denoted N. So, basically, this was M and this is N. Fine. She then gives the piece of paper with sequence B to Tima. Okay, they will get an example, right? So, if it is A, 432633, this sub B will be obtained. How is this B obtained? Let's see. So if you have 4, 4 is copied directly here. And then for the remaining elements, only put those elements which are greater than or equals to its previous element, where AI is greater than or equals to AI minus 1. So is 3 greater than its previous element? No. Is 2? Is 6? Yes, 6 is there. So 6 you will find here. Is 3 greater than or equals to its previous element? No. Is this 3 greater than or equals to previous element? Yes. So that's why you'll find 3 is 3 here. Fine. Anyway, I'll explain the examples again. But then what happens? She then gives this piece of paper with sequence B to Tima. So this is a boy like this. Yeah. A in turn tries to guess the sequence A. Fine, so this girl first converts this A to B, and now this boy has a task of converting this B back to A again. Okay, Tima considers winning in such a highly unlikely game, but still wants to find at least one sequence A such that there could have been originally chosen by Vika. Help him and output any such sequence. So we don't have to actually convert this B to exactly A, but at least one sequence. Such that, so basically we have to find, like this guy, Tima, had to find at least one sequence A that could have been originally chosen by Vika. Okay. Note that the length of sequence A output should not exceed the input sequence length more than 2 lines. Fine, so we'll come back to this constraint later on, but let's see the input and output. Input, each test case, consider multiple test cases. Fine, the first input is T, no issues. For each test case, we are given N, so basically size of sequence P. Right, so length of sequence B is given, and second line of each test case consists of n integers. So basically, our sequence B is defined. The sum of n all test cases does not exceed 2 into 10 power 5. So like, what is this line is? This line is just telling you that you can maybe try complexity of n log n. That's to the best of my understanding. This is what this line means. The sum of test cases is not exceeding 2 into 10 power 5. You can maybe use sorting somewhere. Anyway, so that's not relevant here, but anyway, let's check it there. And what do you have to output? Output each test case 2 lines. First line, output a single integer m. Single integer m, length of the sequence. So basically, yeah, length of sequence. So basically, what we have is we are given b. Okay? We are given b. And we have to find out one possible value of a from which, after applying these operations, you can get b. Right? So you are given b. So we have to find this A, not exactly the one that Vika chose, but just one possible sequence A on which if I apply these two operations, then get P, right? So that's what you will find. Output 2 lines for each test case. First is a single integer M, the length of sequence, basically N, and the second time output M integers. So what you're supposed to find is, we are supposed to find one valid sequence of A on which if we apply those two operations, we can get P. That's a simple question here. Okay, so there's a lot of story written here. But the question, if I break down to you, so what happens is you're doing this question, you'll have to read a question one or two times. Okay, again and again. The question is very simple. You have A, and you apply this operation. You apply an operation. You convert this A. And this B is given to you. Okay, this B is given. This B is given to you. Now, you just return me one possible value of A. Right? So, now what you do is, this B is given to you. Now, you just return me one possible value of A on which, if I apply these two operations, I can get back A. I guess the question is clear. So, let's see the example. So, again, how would you like, how one should think about this question, first of all, if you encounter in contest? Since it is a or b question, try to just think of the most dumb way, basically. How would you go about constructing B from A in the most dumb manner possible? Okay, in most of the cases, that dumb manner would be the correct way. Okay, right. So, I'll just copy the examples from Codeforces. So there were two examples only, and yeah, this is the first example. So let's try to understand it. So this was A, right? And by applying those operations, what are those operations? Applying those operations, we got this B. What are those operations, by the way? Copy this 4, like the first element as it is, and copy AI if AI is greater than equals to AML. So basically, if it is greater than equals to previous element. Is 3 greater than its previous element? No. Is 2 greater than its previous element? No. Right? 2 is not greater than previous element. Is 6 greater than its previous element? Greater than equals to, basically, yes. That's why we're finding 6 here. That's why we'll find 6 here. Right? And let's move to the next element. Is 3 greater than equals to previous element? No. Is 3 greater than equals to previous element? Yes. That's why we'll find this 3 here. Right? So the question is clear. Good. So you are given this, basically, this is your input. This is your input. And this is your input, and what you want to actually convert is you want to convert A. Now let's try building the solution. Okay. So I'm trying to build a possible value of A. Okay, I might not be able to get the exact value of A. If you get it, that's great. But if you don't get it, it's not required. Basically, you just have to find one possible value of the sequence A, such that you can get B back. Right? So how do you get it, by the way? See, it's a no-brainer that the first element will be same, right? Now we'll have to think like this. We're constructing this, and you have to get this B from it, right? So, okay, I'll repeat myself. From this B, I'm trying to convert A such that after applying this operations, I can get B again, right? It's a no-brainer that the first element has to be, like, the first element has to be same, right? This even and this even has to be same, right? Cool. What about, now let's go to the next element. Let's go to the next element here. Now, 6 is greater than equals to 4. 6 is greater than equals to 4. Can I just put 6 as it is here? So basically what I'm doing is I'm building A sequentially. I'm going to first build this part of A, then this part of A, then this part of A, right? So 6 is greater than equals to 4. So can I put it as it is? If I put as it is, will I get this part of the array? Let's see. 4 is put as it is. 4 is put as it is. Now, can 6 be here? Yes, 6 be here because 6 is greater than equals to AML, right? So if this equality is satisfied in B, why do you want to change it? Right? So what I'm saying is, 6 is greater than equals to 4, right? If there was something like this, 4, 6, 9, this was my B. So anyway, you know, the first element has to be same. 6 is greater than equals to 4. Just copy it straight away. Because if this is in your A, this part is in your A, you know that this can be converted, right? First element is copied as it is, and that is greater than or equals to, it will be copied. Then, I could put 9 here, because 9 is greater than or equals to 6, right? So, you're seeing a pattern here that we just need to compare the adjacent element and make our decision. So, let's just see what we can do. So, 6 is greater than or equals to 4, so I can put as it is. Now, let's come back to this 3. Is 3 greater than or equals to 6? No, 3 is not greater than or equals to 6. Now, what should I put here? Basically, what should I put here such that 3 is picked? How will be 3 picked, first of all, if it is greater than or equals to its previous element? So what I can do is maybe greater than or equals to, right? So I'll just put 3 already. Okay, I think I have written, don't think you understand it completely. So what I did is B was given to me, right? I tried constructing A from it. How did I do it? First element, I know, anyway, will be 4. Basically, the first element itself. The second element, what I did is, for rest of the elements, I know that they will be placed, they will be part of A if they are greater than or equals to its previous element. Right? So, then, I'll come to this 6. If it is greater than or equals to 4, I'll just put it as it is, right? Because if we have this, anyway, 6 will be here, right? So from this part, you can get this part, right? Then you move to the next two pairs. So I only need to compare two adjacent pairs. That's the main idea here. I only need to compare two adjacent pairs here. Okay. So let's take one more example. I'll take a bigger example so it makes sense to you. Let's say B, we're given something like this. Let's say 4, 6, 7, 5, and maybe 3, and 9. Fine. So let's take a bigger example. This will clear all the concepts, I believe. So the first element, anyway, has to be same. It will be copied as it is. Now move to the second element. Is it greater than or equals to the previous element? Yeah, if it is greater than or equals to, no need to do anything. Because if from this part, you can get this part, right? Let's move to the next element. Is it greater than or equals to previous element? Yes. Just put as it is. From this part, you can get this part. Why this part? 4 will be copied as it is. 6 is greater than or equals to 4. 7 is greater than or equals to 6. You can get this. Right. Now let's move to the next pair. Next adjacent pair. 5. Is 5 greater than or equals to 7? No. 5 is not greater than or equals to 7. Then, I need to put something here from which I can get 5. The best bet is just put 5 two times, right? If I put 5 two times, what will happen is, till this part you understood, this part will give this. From these two 5s, this 5 is greater than or equals to its previous, so 5 is greater than or equals to its previous guy, so this 5 will be copied. Right? So let's move to the next element. 3. Is 3 greater than or equals to its previous element? No. It is not greater than or equals to the previous element. Then you need to put something here such that 3 is copied there. The simplest way to do is just put 3, right? You can also put 1, actually. You can also put 1, 3. That also works. But I'm just trying to build the simplest kind of solution. I'm just thinking, what if 3 is not greater than or equals to 5? Then what should I put? Let's just put 3, right? So in the end, like what I'm saying is this condition. I'm just following this condition. That's what I'm doing. Right? So I just put 3. I to go to this 9. Is 9 greater than or equals to its previous element? Yes, just put it. Now you can simply verify that from this you can get this. Right? And the constraint that length of sequence should not exceed input sequence by more than 2 times is also obviously followed, right? At the time, we are not adding more than 2 characters. So if the initial sequence length is n, anyway, the worst case you can get 2. And what case can you get 2 and can you guess it? I think you can guess it if you have something in descending order, right? If I give you something like this, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, right? So 5 will be anyway copied, but then you'll have to copy 4, 4. Then for this 3, you'll have to copy 3, 3. From this 2, you'll have to copy 2, 2. And from this 1, you'll have to copy 1. So in this case, it can go to into 1, order 2, right? It won't go exactly into 1 because the first element is copied as it is. So yeah, that's that. So that's actually the solution, actually. What was approach, by the way? I guess we are 15 minutes into this video, and what is approach? The approach is straightforward, basically. From this B, I'm trying to build A. How did I do it? Just copy the first element as it is, and just from comparing the adjacent pairs, we're able to build up the solution, right? So this is like the beauty of constructive algorithms. Let's code it up so that you can completely ingrain this solution into your head. And then let's code it up quickly. So, what was the input? So, the input was basically, first we have to take the test cases input, and then first line of each test case consists of single integer n, the size of a B array, then we take the n input, then we have to define our array B, so maybe I just call it array, and then better. Then I will need to go through the entire array and take input. So that's that. So we have taken the input, I guess. First line was n, and then we find a query B notions. So now we want to actually convert our answer, right? So we define an answer like this, right? So we define an answer. And the first element would be, what is the first element? First element would be array of 0, right? The first element, anyway, you have to copy as it is. So first element will be like this. Then we're going to go through the remaining elements. And there's then n, like plus plus. We're going to go through any elements and should probably turn off this copilot. Anyway, so we'll go to the remaining elements and I'm going to compare. Basically, if array of I is greater than or equals to array of I minus 1, then you can just copy it as it is, right? You can just copy it as it is. then just copy it as it is, no issues, right? So basically, this was the case when 4 followed by 6. So 6 is greater than or equal to 4, you can just copy it as it is because it will be anyway converted to 4, 6, right? And else, if it is not greater than or equal to, then what you need to do? Just push this guy 2 times, right? Just push this guy 2 times. So basically, you had 5 followed by 6, right? You had 5 followed by 6. Then in that case, if you want 6, 5 back, if you want 6, 5, you need to insert 2 times 5, right? I guess we already saw this, so I'm just write it quickly. There you go, fed. Right, so that is that. And how are we supposed to print the output? It's supposed to print 2 lines, right? So first is answer.size, I'm just printing it from the line, and then the answer itself. So we have to go through the array and then print it, right? So I hope you can see this. So the code is pretty simple. Like here we took the input, right? So here we took the input, then we went through every adjacent pairs, right? So we went through every adjacent pairs. So here, let's have a good time to discuss about time complexity. We went through every adjacent pairs. So all in all, we run this order of n loop, order of n2. And if it was like, if a guy was greater than or equal to the previous element, we can just put it straight away, right? There was no issues with that. And if it was not, we need to put it 2 times. Or like one approach, one people might suggest, you can also put 1 here. That also works. But yeah, fine, no issues. And because the constraints are very less, so I'll just push this element 2 times. So no issues there. But I'll just run it and see if it works. So I've just copied down some test cases and see if it works. So first was size, right? So then we printed the size of the answer, and okay, I also have to print new line after this. Yeah. Just run it. This is the output. And let me just verify with Codeforces if it's correct. 6. So okay, the output doesn't seem correct exactly to Codeforces, but like the idea is it won't be exactly similar to Codeforces because the strategy that we use is different. So what you need to actually see is can you get this like from this 4633, can you get this 463? Obviously you can, right? So 4, 6 and then 3, right? So you don't need to actually get the output, like you need not get the output exactly correct. Let me just quickly submit this code and see if it works. Yeah, it works.